Hello, this is Bill Morgan, president of Parker University here at Parker Seminars in Las Vegas, Nevada. And with me today is Don Dishman. Don, tell us a little bit about yourself.
Well, thanks, Bill. I'm really pleased to be here. I'm the dean of graduate programs and special projects in the College of Chiropractic now at Parker University. Mm-hmm. And I'm really excited about our program in neuroscience and clinical neuroscience. It's a master's degree program. And a great deal of functional rehabilitation is woven into the curriculum, and it's really exciting. And Parker is moving forward with a neural center of excellence in which we'll see complicated neurological cases, and as a training facility, it's going to be fantastic as well for the master's program.
Yeah, we're really excited to have you here. It's a really good catch for Parker. So, you know, how should this affect the average chiropractor in the field, the understanding of functional neurology or neuroplasticity, or where we're going with this?
Yeah, the field of chiropractic, as you know, has really embraced modern clinical neuroscience. In fact, chiropractic is neuroscience in mm-hmm. many ways. And so it's really exploding, and we're seeing a paradigm shift, I believe, in our whole profession of an interest in managing cases that we thought maybe we wouldn't be able to manage before. And so there's a lot of patients that the pill doesn't work for. They have mm-hmm. neural dysfunction, and taking a pill doesn't work. And so we have some fairly sophisticated methods to find out where their problem is and what can we do to help them. And that's in the realm of chiropractic and chiropractic neurology. So our average chiropractor, I'm getting a lot more questions of how can I incorporate these techniques and these skill sets into my practice for those types of cases.
Yeah, and we have these two neuromaster's degree programs. We have a functional neurology program coming in the offing. But I think it's a combination of this is our time where we realize that we want to embrace neuroplasticity, the adjustment, nutrition, exercise. The things come together to give these people back their livelihood, their ability to function.
Absolutely, and that patient-centered paradigm that our profession has embraced, the neurology part of it blends in so well with the nutrition and the overall wellness scheme. But the neurology portion of it is really coming into the forefront, and you're right, that well-rounded care for the patient, neurology is a key core to that.
So here we have this upswell of these complicated, high-functioning neurological conditions, autism, obsessive compulsive disorder, and it seems to be rising in the pediatric population. And as these folks get into the workforce, what can we do to help them maximize the expression of life?
Well, and that's a great point, is that many of these conditions that we see in neurology and neurological dysfunction, they're not ablative lesions, they're not tumors, they're not, you cut the tissue, they're developmental. And many of these functioning adults, we need to take care of them earlier on. And that's the thing I think we're going to see. The effect on humankind will start in a developing nervous system. And so it's really exciting to see, frankly, some fairly simple things, if they were to have been done to the individual, can radically change their life.
A little tweak here. Yep. And I think we agree that if you're taking Neurontin or Lyrica, you've already lost the battle. You're fighting a defensive battle with that. You're not making changes in the neuroplasticity or their nervous system.
In fact, there's a growing body of literature of a list of very common drugs that actually impede neuroplasticity.
Oh, really?
Yes. So when we place somebody in through a fairly intense, high intensity, high frequency, but short term neurorehabilitation that's a program designed for them, that's an issue we have to consider, is the list of drugs they're on, and some of these are known inhibitors of neuroplasticity.
Oh my goodness. Mm-hmm. So what advice would you give to a chiropractor interested in learning more about neuroplasticity and having a neurology-based practice?
Well, there's several avenues. I mean, you can be board certified in chiropractic neurology. That's a 300-hour board specialty certification. Mm-hmm. Our master's degree program in clinical neuroscience, we've designed to kind of sort of a highlight reel of those salient topics and a really good in-depth understanding of the neuraxis. We have to know the parts to fix it. So I think we really do well in that part. And then also, not necessarily the full scope, but to have the skill set for those concussion patients that you've seen or you see, that you really, beyond the traditional chiropractic measures, maybe you don't really know what to do. So you would pick up this extra tools in your toolbox to try and help out those patients that we see so frequently.
Well, we're just blessed to have you at Parker and creating these master programs in our Neuro Center of Excellence. We have this initial Neuro Center we're building right now that's should be done pretty soon, about 5,000 square feet, but we have a much larger project that we're going to build over the next 5 years. And I'm really looking forward to, doing
excited.
Great things.
I think it's, for me, it's the culmination of 30 or 40 years worth of study in neurosciences to see this profession moving forward. And I appreciate your vision to do it.
Well, thank you so much for spending time with us.
Thank you.